Continuing with our discussion on end effector and sensor commands, now suppose instead of binary signals on and off, we had got analog signals. So in this case, just look at this. Define volt 1 is equal to output port 105. So what this means is, at some point in the program, volt 1 will be assigned. Let us say some value, some computation is done and some value is assigned, let us say 4.5 volts. Then signal volt 1, right now what has happened? Volt 1 has become 4.5 volts. So when you give the command signal volt 1, that computed value 4.5 volts will be sent to the external device through the output port 105. Let us look at it once again. I have an output port 105. It is associated with the variable volt 1. Somewhere in the program, volt 1 is some computation is done and volt 1 is assigned a value, for example 4.5 volts. Then if a command comes signal volt 1, what does it mean? 4.5 volts will be sent to an external device through this output port 105. Similarly, suppose you have defined volt 3 input port 115. Wait volt 3. So what happens is, wait means it suspends the program execution till this whatever has required to happen here happens. So the program execution waits for the value of the signal on the input port 115 to be greater than the volt 3 that has been computed in the program. So within the program, volt 3 would have been given a value, and that volt 3 is a variable associated with input port 115. So when I say wait volt 3, the program execution waits for the value of the signal on input port 115 to be greater than the value that is therein, greater than or equal to the value that is therein volt 3. Now you have another set of statements in the same category. Those are called the react statements. This gives an interrupt kind of capability to the robot programming. That is, it is able to interrupt the execution of the regular program. Now an example is react 17, safety. So now this, when you see a statement like this itself, it means that it is a binary signal that is going to come to input port 17. Okay. So when input line 17, when a statement like this comes, input line 17 is continuously monitored, and when a change in its value occurs, any change, high to low, low to high, the program branches from the regular program to a subroutine that is called safety. In that, what is supposed to be done is written over there. Okay. Another variation of that is react I17 safety. So what is the difference between this and this? React I means immediate suspension of the regular program execution immediately, and manipulator motion also stops immediately. Here it is not immediate suspension. The branching is done after the current program statement is executed or the manipulator completes its current movement. But here the program execution, regular program execution, is immediately suspended, and the manipulator motion also is stopped immediately. Similarly, you can assign several levels of priority to these react statements. So for example, we have shown here react 17 safety priority 1. Now suppose I have another other levels of priority. Let us say that this 17 had a change in its value and we have branched to the safety subroutine. Now at that time, another react statement with priority, for example 4, also has a change in its value at the input line. So what will happen? Because this has got priority 1 and the other one is priority 4, this safety subroutine is allowed to execute completely before the branching off to the priority 4's signals, say a subroutine. If it was the other way around, suppose I was executing a subroutine of priority 4, what happens is that one will be suspended and the branching will go off to the higher, the lower priority, that is the, if you say priority 1, that is the highest priority over here, the branching will take place to that particular subroutine. Now the same way you can have for react statements, you can have analog signals. So react 117 4.5 safety priority 3 means, if the input signal on port 117 is greater than or equal to 4.5, whatever the units are, let us say volts, then we have to transfer to the subroutine safety. So that is the meaning of an analog react statement. So if the input signal on 117 is greater than or equal to 4.5, let's say volts, then we have to transfer to the subroutine safety.